I am Mr. Nagesh R. Tambake, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss Unconventional Machining Process, Part 5. In this particular session, we are going to discuss Abrasive Water Jet Machining. As we have seen previously, introduction, then electro-discharge machining, electrochemical machining process, ultrasonic machining process. In this session, we are going to discuss abrasive water jet machining process. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to understand process of abrasive water jet machining. In this particular session, we are going to discuss what is abrasive water jet machining, that is called as AWJM, its major component, its working principle, advantages, disadvantages and applications. What is abrasive water jet machining? Now think about the medium that we are using over here for this particular process. The medium that we are using for this particular process is abrasive and water. Now in this process, abrasive water jet machining is non-traditional or non-conventional machining process. In this process, the mechanical energy of water and abrasive phases are used to achieve material removal or machining. Abrasive water jet machining developed in 1974 to clean metal prior to surface treatment of the metal. Now we'll discuss regarding some of the major components of this particular process. This is a schematic figure that is shown over here. Now we'll discuss major components one by one. Hydraulic pump. This is the hydraulic pump. It is used to circulate the water from the storage tank during the machining process. The pump delivers water intensifier at lower pressure of about 5 bars. A booster is also used, which increases the initial pressure of water to 11 bar before delivering it to the intensifier. Next one, hydraulic intensifier. This is the hydraulic intensifier. It is used to increase the pressure of water to a very high pressure. It receives the water from the pump at 4 bar and increases its pressure up to 3000 to 4000 bar. See, imagine how much increase in pressure we will get with this hydraulic intensifier. Now next one, accumulator. This is the accumulator. It stores the high pressurized water temporarily. It supplies that fluid when a large amount of pressure energy is required. It eliminates pressure fluctuation conditions in the machining process. Now mixing chamber or a tube. Here there is a mixing chamber and a tube. It is a vacuum chamber where the mixing of abrasive particle into water takes place. From the side we are passing a abrasive slurry, and from this wall the water is coming over here. So therefore here there is a mixing chamber. Due to that, abrasive slurry, abrasive and water, they are mixing together. Now next one is the control valve. This is the control valve. It controls the pressure and direction of the water jet. Now next one is the valve, or that is also called as flow regulator. This is the valve or flow regulator. The flow of the water is regulated with the help of flow regulator. So how much pressure that we want, that much pressure we can take with the help of flow regulator. Now we will discuss regarding the working principle of abrasive water jet machining process. First, water is filled in water reservoir. It provides water for cutting operation. A pump sucks water from water reservoir and sends it to intensifier. Intensifier increases the water pressure from 4 bar to 4000 bars. It sends water to accumulator, which stores some pressurized water. This high pressure water now sends through tubing system to nozzle. The water passes through flow regulator valve, which regulates the flow. Now this high pressure water entered into the nozzle, and at the same time the abrasive is also going to enter. The abrasive here that we are using, that is again silicon carbide. Nozzle converts that mixture pressure energy of that water into a kinetic energy. A high speed, high pressurized water jet is available at the nozzle exit. This water jet sends to strike at work surface. It erodes the metal contact surface. Thus, metal removal takes place. This process is having certain advantages. It does not change mechanical properties of workpiece. It is used for machining heat sensitive materials. It is environment friendly because it does not form any dust particle and used water as cutting fluid. Good surface finish that we are getting because between the workpiece and the tool we have maintained a equal gap throughout the machining. Therefore, we will get good surface finish with this process. No physical tool is required, as here tool is acting like a mixture of water and the abrasive. Therefore, no physical tool is required. It can cut both soft and hard materials. For machining soft materials, water jet machining is used, and for machining hard materials, abrasive water jet machining is used. It is ideal process for laser reflective materials where laser beam machining cannot be used. Lower cost of machining. Certain limitations are there. It cannot be used for machining materials which degrades in presence of water. Low metal removal rate is there. High initial cost that we need to spend. Thick material cannot be machined easily. Now certain applications are there for this particular process. It is used in aerospace industries as we are getting close tolerances and high surface finish. Abrasive jet machining is used to cut hard material like stainless steel, titanium, inconel, etc. It is used to machine or cut reinforced plastic, which is a hard material that also we can cut with the help of abrasive water jet machining. Used to cut stone, which reduces dust in the environment. So whenever we are crushing the stone by conventional method, that time large dust is getting produced and that will spoil the environment. But here, as water is the medium, therefore whatever the dust is formed, that is mixed with the water, and dust cannot be in the environment. Therefore, it is environment friendly process. Used to machine PCBs. Now for further reading, I will recommend some of the books. Workshop Technology, Volume 2 by Raghuvanshi, and second one, Production Technology by PC Sharma, that is also called as HMT Handbook. Thank you.